I've now automated everything, and I'm going to show you how I've connected my shortcuts from getting ready to podcast or record a video, control all the smart home devices in my studio, control my video switcher and audio interface in one place, the powerful apps that let me automate and integrate with shortcuts, and how the new Stream Deck brings it all together. Now, this video is not sponsored by Stream Deck. I've actually had Stream Decks for years. The amount of dust on this and the USB-A attest to that, but Elgato did send me the Stream Deck Plus with the new knob so I could play around with that, and they sent me the network dock, which allows me to power it with power over Ethernet, and doesn't take up a USB-C port. But this video is sponsored by OBSBOT, but we'll get to that later. So step one was setting up the Stream Deck. Now, my old Stream Deck, all it did was control my ATEM Mini Pro, but previously I could only control either the ATEM or run the Elgato software. Well, that's changed now. So here I can actually have multiple profiles. I have my studio profile on the Stream Deck and one just for controlling the ATEM, and I can switch between them on the fly on the actual Stream Deck. I'll go through everything that I have programmed, but I can click this knob on the left and switch between my ATEM controls, and in this profile, I have a bunch of shortcuts and even multiple pages that allows me to do things like start audio hijack sessions, start a screen recording with CleanShot X, and more. Now, the first thing I wanted to do was automate my video scenes. So you'll see here along the top, I have several color options that will control my entire studio. I basically created an entire shortcuts folder, and these are the shortcuts that are running on the Stream Deck. And these shortcuts are just one action shortcut. I do have some more complicated shortcuts I'm running on the Stream Deck, and I'll show you those. But this is just running my different video color scenes. Then to add a shortcut to the Stream Deck, what I do is go up to File, and then you can add a shortcut to your dock. You don't have to keep it there. And then once the shortcut is in the dock, right-click it, then go to Show in Finder. Then it's going to reveal a folder where all the shortcuts that you've added to the dock live. Then all you have to do is drag this shortcut onto the Stream Deck, and that's it. The shortcut is ready to run directly on the Stream Deck. You can also just right-click the shortcut here and then quickly add to dock. Now, I like changing the colors for every video I'm filming, and so I have my most used colors here on the top of the Stream Deck. And I'll show you, I can run them live. So right now I'm in video blue. Same thing with orange. Tap that, whole studio changes. And I can add as many of these colors as I want. Here's red. And this is not just changing the lights. These are HomeKit scenes that actually lower my shades, turn on my key light, fill light, and hair light, and gets my entire studio ready to film. Then I have a done recording and a done working scene, which also affects everything here in the studio. Now you can watch my entire smart home tour. I'll link it above because I talk about all the Hue lights, Aqara, and other smart lights here in the studio that make all this color possible. Also my smart shades and 150 plus smart home devices. So check that out. Now, when you get the Stream Deck Plus, which has the knobs and this little screen here, you're limited to the 8 buttons here, but you can also click each knob and turn each knob and program something separately. So I have this right knob programmed to when I turn it, that will actually go to page 2, and you can even add multiple pages on your Stream Deck or have even more controls. To do that here in the Stream Deck app, you can click on one of these knobs, and I'm using the action trigger. And when you use the action trigger, you can actually choose 3 different actions. What it does when you click the knob, and then what it does when you turn left and turn right. You can even have these knobs change function between different pages, but I've actually pinned them so the knobs are always the same. So this far right knob, I can go between the pages and you can see those controls stay the same. Now I've actually changed the background image, which you could do in the Stream Deck software, but the knobs always perform the same function. This third knob affects the dimness of the actual Stream Deck display. And if I click this knob, that actually gets me ready to record primary technology. You can listen to primary technology anywhere and watch it here on YouTube. I'll put a link above. I also adjust my system volume using this knob here, and I can adjust my studio display brightness with this far left knob. To do that, you can actually program hotkeys to the Stream Deck. So I have the turn left and turn right as the dim or brighten my studio display hotkey. That's under the system section here in the Stream Deck settings, and then hotkey right here. You can also have it just open applications, run scripts, and again, because it integrates with shortcuts pretty easily, you can really have it do whatever. And that's where Audio Hijack comes in, because I have multiple shortcuts that are now on the Stream Deck that will start and stop different sessions in Audio Hijack. But before I get to that, if you're thinking of adding video to your podcast or want to significantly upgrade your camera quality on the Mac, that's where today's sponsor OBSBOT comes in. This is the OBSBOT Meet 2 4K webcam. It's super compact, but it is super powerful. First, not only does it have a thread so you can attach it to a tripod, but it's also magnetic and comes with this stand. This can hook onto your monitor, and then the OBSBOT Meet 2 just connects magnetically. And if you do that and you want to record some shorts, then you can even put it in vertical mode. Also comes with a magnetic privacy cover in the box. Now the OBSBOT Meet 2 is totally plug and play. You just connect it to your Mac, You can select it here to record in QuickTime or your app of choice, and you're ready to go. And you can see, even in low light conditions, you get incredible video quality. Download the OBSBOT Center app, and then you can change the resolution and go all the way up to 4K 30. It has auto brightness, auto white balance, and auto focus. So if you do want to record maybe some YouTube content, you could hold something up to the camera, it will focus on that, and then remove it and it'll focus back on your face. It even has gesture controls for zooming and following around the frame. So I could just hold up the letter L with my fingers and it will auto zoom to my face. Hold it up again and it'll zoom out. And if you'll be walking around the frame, you can just hold up five fingers and that's gonna turn on the auto follow. Now if I move towards this side of the frame, the OBSBOT will automatically follow me, keeping me in frame and centered. I'm gonna record a 4K clip here in QuickTime so you can see the full quality. And what you're seeing now is that 4K 30 from the OBSBOT Meet 2. It also has a half inch CMOS center and an f1.8 aperture, again, which really helps it in those low light conditions. This is still the OBSBOT Meet 2 video of me down here in the corner, but you can get it in three different colors. And even though it's super affordable at full price of $130, there's a big sale going on. You can get 28% off the OBSBOT Meet 2, the 4K AI webcam, and you can even get 21% off the Meet SE. That's their 1080p version, and those links and discount codes are down in the description. And my thanks to OBSBOT for sponsoring this video. All right, now let's talk about Audio Hijack and the Stream Deck. So Audio Hijack actually has great controls inside Shortcuts. And one of the things I do every day is record Primary Tech Daily. That's a benefit of those who pay to support Primary Technology Podcast. And Audio Hijack allows you to run JavaScript for more complicated automations, but you can simply run or stop a single session. So here I have a session to start recording Primary Tech solo. I also have all my sessions up here in the menu bar. You can see my video session is running right now. That's how I record the audio for all my videos. But if I wanted to run the Primary Tech solo session, now all I have to do is tap this button on the Stream Deck, and that's actually gonna start that session running. You can see that session is now also running here in Audio Hijack in the menu bar, and one of the features I love about Audio Hijack is the audio meters can be put here in the menu bar so I can see it there too. Then if I wanna stop that session, all I have to do is press PTS stop here on the Stream Deck. You'll see that session is gonna stop here in the menu bar of Audio Hijack, and those meters disappeared from the menu bar. I love being able to run that from the Stream Deck because those settings never change. It automatically puts today's date in Audio Hijack. And just to show you, that session in Audio Hijack, it records to a specific folder, and I can automatically put today's date. So none of those settings ever change. All I've ever done is run and stop that session, and now I can do it from the Stream Deck. The same is true for the weekly Thursday show of Primary Technology, and so I created another shortcut, but this one's a little more complicated, because not only do I set a HomeKit scene, which gets my studio ready to film, I also open Riverside in the Brave web browser. That's where we record the video and audio for Primary Tech. And because this is a significant shortcut, I didn't want to accidentally tap it using all the buttons up here. So it's actually a click of the third knob. So when I click this knob, it's going to run that shortcut in the background. So I'm going to tap to run. That's also going to open Brave, and then it should go into split screen. Notion also is automatically opening up, going to the latest episode, and it also snapped into that 50-50 split view. And it also started the recording session for Primary Tech. So you can see here now I have those two sessions running, the video that I'm still recording here, and our Primary Tech session, which records both me and the audio through Brave, so I have a backup of Jason's recording. Now, I'm never going to forget to start recording the pre-show, and I can go directly to the Riverside Studio and Notion document, all from a shortcut, run from the Stream Deck. Then when I'm ready to stop recording, I actually have that as the fourth knob click, and when I click that, it's going to stop the recording of the Audio Hijack session. You see my filming lights just turned off, my blackout shade is now raising, you probably hear it in the background, and the Primary Tech session actually stopped here in Audio Hijack, so I know the audio stopped recording as well. I can also add Quit Brave and Notion, this way those also go away when I'm done recording. So pretty fun animation. Now let's actually use the Stream Deck to go to a different color scene. Let's go to the purple one. You'll see my filming lights are gonna turn on. The colored lights, all the Philips Hue are actually purple now, and my blackout shades are closing. You can watch the light here on my face and it'll change. And now I'm ready to record again. So love being able to orchestrate all of that through Shortcuts, Audio Hijack, using the different HomeKit scenes, and the Stream Deck. Now I can go to the second page on my Stream Deck by turning this fourth knob. I have some other shortcuts to run different Audio Hijack sessions. I also have one just to turn off my ceiling fan because that's something I do often. And I did figure out how to use MIDI controls to control my Rodecaster Pro 2. So here in the Stream Deck app, this is a plugin you actually have to install, but it's the generic MIDI plugin. If you go to the plugin store and then just search for MIDI, you'll see this generic MIDI plugin is totally free and you can download and install it to your Stream Deck software. And then if you're wanting to control the Rodecaster Pro 2 specifically, you do have to turn on MIDI control. Real quick, just to show you, you would go to the Rodecaster app, go over to System, and then turn on MIDI control. Once that's enabled, then you can drag this CC NRPN button over to the Stream Deck. Now, I called it Mute. I actually designed that icon in Elgato's like icon designer. I titled it Mute. It's muting channel 1 on the Rodecaster Pro 2. And while it's not labeled here, command 27 is mute. And then button type is toggle, so it'll go between mute and unmute. And then here at the bottom, you want to expand the MIDI ports menu and make sure to choose your audio interface. This is the Rodecaster Pro 2. It would also work with the Duo. And you can also control Rodecaster video here through the Stream Deck. Once MIDI control is on and you use all these settings, now you can mute a channel on the Rodecaster Pro 2. So if you watch channel 1 over there in the Rodecaster Pro 2, you see it just got muted when I tapped the mute button. And if I click it again, it's going to unmute that channel. Now, if the Rodecaster Pro 2 was a little closer or on my desk, yes, I could just use the actual mute button on that fader. But I don't like the Rodecaster Pro 2 taking up space or being too close on my desk. I need the most amount of space for filming, and so it's on an arm off the desk and just out of reach when I'm recording a podcast. So this one little button on the Stream Deck helps a lot. Now, two other apps that make all these automations possible. The next one is Companion. Now, I use this with my old Stream Deck. It is a little complicated to set up. You do have to connect your ATEM Mini via the IP address, so it needs to be connected to Ethernet and your network. Then Companion will also recognize whatever control surfaces. You see, here's my Stream Deck Plus. It was connected to my old Stream Deck. You'll see that here. And you do need to program each button and then move it around. But once you do all that, now you can create a profile. And so I have it here in the Stream Deck software where I can go over to ATEM. And these are all my ATEM controls. I can cut between different cameras. One thing you can't do on the actual ATEM Mini Pro panel is put something in the preview window. There's just no buttons to put anything in preview there. And also, why don't I just use the panel for control? Well, it's way over there and I can't reach it with all the stuff that I have over here to actually record my podcasts and videos. A different desk setup would allow me maybe to use that, but I think I actually prefer the controls here on the Stream Deck. So I have my multi-view up here so you can see me actually changing things and then the ATEM controls here on the Stream Deck. But for instance, if I wanted to put camera 2 in program, you see that just changed by tapping it here on the Stream Deck. I can also change what's in preview. So I'll click the Mac preview. That's actually an extended display of my Mac Studio that's now in preview. And if I wanted to, I could use something like the auto command, which is actually a click of this knob, and that's gonna fade between the two. Let me try to get both in the frame here, but if I click this knob, you'll see it's gonna auto transition from what's in preview to what's live. And one thing I do during my weekly Shortcuts live streams is I'll put camera 2 in program like that, and then I can activate picture-in-picture just with a button here on the Stream Deck. There you'll see my picture-in-picture is there. I'll do it again. I can just tap PIP here on the Stream Deck, and it's gonna go between putting picture-in-picture on screen and taking it off. Then I can go back to camera 1 easily, and I have all the controls I need for my ATEM right here on the Stream Deck. By the way, if you've been enjoying the Shortcuts in this video and you want to tune into my weekly live streams, I would love if you join my Shortcuts community. You can go to shortcut.bot. There you can watch all the live stream recordings. I stream every Wednesday at 12 noon. You can see all the events here. Those are all recorded and new Shortcuts every week. Plus I take live requests. In addition, you can search my Shortcuts database to find Shortcuts by device, Apple intelligence. You get access to my Shortcuts GPT, which helps you build Shortcuts using APIs, match text commands, and more. I share a Shortcut of the Week where you'll see it first here before any video on YouTube or live stream. And you can even watch my Shortcuts 101 videos without ads right here in the community. You get all those benefits when you support at shortcut.bot. Appreciate you becoming a member and supporting the channel there. Now, in order to use those Bitfocus plugins, I did create a second profile, and you can have multiple profiles and then quickly switch between those profiles. So you'll see here, I have another action on a knob that allows me to go back to my main profile. So I can click this left knob, go back to my main profile with all those Shortcuts and different audio hijack settings, click it again, and I'm back on my ATEM page. Previously, I had my Stream Deck doing only the ATEM, but now I can do all of this, switch profiles quickly, go to different pages just by turning a knob. I love all of this. And one last integration, I'll talk about CleanShot X. I do a ton of screen recordings in my videos. I'm literally doing one right now. And CleanShot X is the most powerful app to do it. I've talked about it in past videos, but I created hotkeys for starting a screen recording and then also capturing an area and capturing the previous area. Now, why is that beneficial? Well, when I watch a live Apple event or if they're streaming one, I like to take screenshots of the live stream and then share those images on social media during the event with whatever new announcements. And so CleanShot X allows me to capture an area, and I actually created a hotkey for that and then put that hotkey here on the Stream Deck. So when I click this, now I get the cursor on screen. I can select a portion, so I would select the video on YouTube of Apple's live stream. And when I let go, it's going to capture that. You'll see right here it was added to my screen recordings folder, and there's the screenshot. And now I have another hotkey to capture the same area, so I don't have to click and drag every time. I'll move this window a little bit so you see exactly the area that it's capturing, and then I hotkeyed that right here on the Stream Deck for capture previous area. So all I have to do is click that on the Stream Deck. That's going to capture another screen recording, but of the same area. And you see, because I moved the window, now that screenshot is a little off. But this way I could have the video in place while I'm watching an Apple event, just keep clicking that button on my Stream Deck and it will keep capturing screenshots of the video, like those bento box scenes and all of that. But as you can see, I'm still not done yet. I can add a control here and then I can even add multiple pages. Here in the Stream Deck app, I can click this plus icon and have a whole other page of actions and still navigate them all by turning this knob. So I'm gonna be adding even more shortcuts and automations here. So get subscribed if you wanna see that. I'm also gonna look to see how I can integrate this with Raycast. Yes, I did finally download, install it, and I'm playing around with it. It is clearly powerful and has incredible shortcuts actions. So I'm gonna be building those out pretty soon too. By the way, if you wanna see my entire process for capturing an Apple event using CleanShot and how I make the podcast and video after the fact, I have a video on my entire process right up here. Get subscribed, hit that like button if you have any questions about Stream Deck, CleanShot, whatever it is, let me know down in the comments. I'll put links to all of this stuff down in the description as well. Things like the companion app if you want to control an ATEM, and also the Stream Deck Plus. And if you've not seen any of my shortcut videos before, I have like 60 plus. I'll actually put the entire playlist right here. Just binge them all. Spend a Saturday, watch a bunch of videos, watch them on repeat. I think you'll enjoy them. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.